This is Jayne. This is her very first time in a power parachute. This was just like any other flight. We had like 10 mile an hour winds most of the day. They were forecasted to drop down to 5, even less after 8 o'clock. It's about what time we left, was about 8. She wanted to go up and fly over her son's house, which is about 12 miles north of where we're at right now. The skies were good. The air was smooth. We did have some clouds. It looked like they were mostly cirrostratus clouds. So away we went. Everything was good. Air was smooth. I think I already said that. So sit back and enjoy the ride. We'll see how it goes. Are you ready?
I am.
Pretty smooth ride. Once in a while, just a couple thermos, nothing serious. She's enjoying the flight, looking around. Going over, I can't remember what lake it was, a couple fishermen down there, thought they'd give them a show. And so we're heading to Luther. So the trip continues. Favorite part to fly is farm country. You always got a place to land, but sometimes you got to get there too. So, and everything's still going good. We're getting closer to the little town of Luther. We'll buzz that in a minute. Let's take a look. Smoke at my buddy's house. found a son's house, so we give them a little show too. Here, I want to just not touch down, but get down low and slow. I really love flying farm country. So we're going to buzz that, and then if you notice out to the west there, it's getting a little bit weird looking. There was nothing on the radar when I checked it for the weather before we left. But you know how them guys are sometimes. So I figured we'd fly this and then head it for home. Again on the way back. So here we got about 6 miles to go back to the landing field. Straight south, that's the shortest route. The other way, where I've got hit and miss farm fields and some open clearings, is about 8 miles out of our way. So I thought we'd go this way, but that power line right there is a 72,000 volt. And my chute is about 40 feet wide, 35 feet. I've really never measured it, but it's wide. And I think a road is what, 24 feet. So yeah, I think I'm gonna fly to the left. You'll see a valley down through there where it's pretty sparsely populated with trees, and a guy could land there if he had to. So that's where we're gonna go. Let's see what happens. Remember right, we're about 800 feet right here. We had some, you know, cruise distance. If we had land, we could find a spot. I think this is also about the time when the wind started to pick up, and you'll see shortly. finally got Bumpy. We were all over the place, and the camera stabilization was on too, so it was the roughest I've ever flown in, and I don't care to do it again. Trooper Jayne back, she didn't really know what to expect. I think that helped her out. She thought I had everything under control, which I'm talking to you today, so let's watch some more. This point right here, we turned and we headed east. I got to fly over my runway and get turned around because the wind was coming out of the west. So we're gonna try to get turned around and get down on the ground. They're not moving. It was just up 400 feet, 300 feet, whatever we were. So there's a runway below us. We're going to go down, turn around, and get her on the ground. That's the plan. Thinking to myself, you know, what would I have done different? Maybe we should have took the extra 8 miles. We would have had some farm country to land on, and if it would have got that bad, I would have just put it down in the field and wrapped the chute up and got a ride home. But you know, as I'm sitting here in an easy chair, it's easy to say what I would have done or could have done, should have done. But I fly tomorrow in a second. Next time, I'll probably be watching the clouds a little more and somebody comes over and wants a ride and say, yeah, it's not that bad out, then I'll just tell them to watch this video.
Were you nervous?
I was.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
I've seen guys ask before how wide your runway should be. Just as wide as you can get it.